Welcome back to another episode of Vladflix. Today, after many requests, I decided to take a trip to discover some of the flavors of India.
Well, since we still can travel internationally, I decided to hop in my car and drive about 1 mile from my house to the local Indian market. I was able to find a lot of inspiration from the many spices and fruits they had, among other things, throughout that store. I was super excited to get home and make these cocktails for you. Today we will try 4 drinks, and we will start with one of the most famous traditional Indian drinks, the Lassi. The traditional Lassi is made from yogurt, water and salt, and it comes from the most popular Indian state, Uttar Pradesh, and I just found out that there is only one of 29 states in India. So we are going to make a sweeter version of the mango lassi with alcohol. Let's add about 50 grams of frozen mango. Would you believe India is the largest producer of fruits in the world? And with 24 different varieties, mangoes are one of their most popular fruits. Now you can add a half cup of milk of your choice. I will be using oat milk. Now we will add the yogurt. Yogurt is one of the reasons why this drink is considered good for your digestive health because of the probiotics you will get from it. But not sure how much this matters once you add alcohol. Oh, speaking of alcohol, since this will be a special version of lassi, I will add some spiced rum to this traditionally non-alcoholic drink. Let's make it extra cold by blending it with ice. You can choose any type of glass you have in your home bar, just make sure it's cold. Finally, we will garnish the drink with some ground cardamom, which is a popular spice in India. Just don't put too much since it might make your lassi slightly astringent. It's unusual, I never tried a drink like that. I do believe this one would be better if it were sweetened up a bit more, so feel free to add sugar or add honey to match your preference. Jaljeera is popular in the north because it's a cooling drink and it gets hot there. It tastes like an Indian flavored lemonade, so today it is 93% humidity in Mumbai. Shout out to anyone watching from there. Okay, the jaljira drink is usually made with water and jaljira powder. You can make your own powder by combining cumin, ginger, black pepper, mint, black salt, some fruit powder and chili or hot pepper powder. Then you get this. Or you can just buy it on Amazon as I did and skip many steps involved in making it. Today we are going to draw out that minty flavor and make a jaljira mojito. Squeeze a half ounce of lime juice into the glass and then add a half ounce of simple syrup or as commonly used in the mojito, add demerara sugar to help balance out the sourness from the lime. Now it's time to add the mint. While many bartenders will choose to muddle the mint, I find that light smoking help release enough of the oils. Well, if you decide to muddle, just don't muddle too much or it will make your drink bitter. Next, add 1.5 ounces of your favorite rum and about a teaspoon of the jaljira powder to the mix. Let's continue with the extra cold drink theme and add crushed ice to this mojito. The crushed ice will melt faster than large cubes, which will help balance out the many flavors of this mojito, and it will also provide more surface area of ice, which will make the drink colder. Once you add the ice, top the mojito off with about 2 ounces of soda water and garnish with the freshest mint sprig you can find. This is one of the most unusual flavors I have ever tried. It reminded me of sort of seasoning you would use for cooking, but it adds such an interesting flavor to this mojito, and to be honest, I really love it. It adds a different sourness, and I recommend trying it in the mojito, but I sure will try to mix it in other cocktails. Next, we're going to make a tamarind whiskey sour. Tamarinds are bean-like pods that are filled with seeds. The seeds are surrounded by a pulp that becomes sweet and sour as it ripens. For this drink, we need a tamarind paste. To prepare it, you can peel the outer shell off, soak the seeds pulp in hot water and let it soak for about an hour. Then you can strain the pulp so you are left with a thick paste. Boil it for about 5 minutes and then let it cool. Or you can do what I did and then just buy it at the store for $1.99 and save yourself the trouble. I will take a tablespoon of hot water and mix it with a tablespoon of tamarind paste to make it more like a syrup. Now let's prepare our homemade sour mix by squeezing 3/4 ounce of fresh lemon juice, adding 1/2 ounce of simple syrup, and the traditional way to get the sour foamy is to add egg whites. But on this channel we don't use eggs and always replace them with aquafaba that yields the same results. And of course we can't make an episode about Indian cocktails and not include whiskey. Indians drink about half of the world's whiskey and Jack Daniels is one of their favorites. So let's add 2 ounces of Jack. Our last ingredient is that flavorful tamarind syrup we made. It's hard to describe this flavor if you haven't tried it before, but it is sweet and tangy at the same time, sort of like a date, but also sour. 1/4 ounces will be enough to maintain a good balance for this cocktail. Like we usually do with whiskey sour, let's give it a dry shake. Now I will add ice, and while I shake, let's enjoy some beautiful views of India. And for the best cocktail presentation, I will select my favorite Japanese glass that was proudly made in India. Now strain the cocktail over the fresh ice, a couple of dashes of bitters and lemon zest add to the top, and now this delicious cocktail is complete. This cocktail color is like nothing else, and it tastes even better than I expected. It goes well with whiskey, but let me know if there are any other flavors you think I should pair a tamarind with. We will take the 4th most widely grown fruit in India, the guava, and turn it into guava juice for our last cocktail. We will use only 2 ingredients, so let's mix them in the highball glass. Guava pairs nicely with coconut. I'm going to pour 1.5 ounces of Malibu rum over ice, top it off with our homemade guava juice and stir. It's a nice tasty summer cocktail, but the guava juice is a bit creamy and not the perfect texture for a highball drink. I think we can improve this. Let's grab our blender again and add 1.5 ounces of Malibu rum, followed by about 4 ounces of the guava juice. Now let's add ice and blend the sweetness up. Pour into a chilled glass, and it's optional, but I will use a fresh guava for the garnish. This is an incredible combination, and the only way it could taste better is if you subscribe to this channel. Thank you guys for watching, hit the like button, and I'll see you very soon in the next video.